Walking through the data center, I remember the first time that I walked into this building. I remember walking down the lines and feeling like I was at a grocery store that had been converted into a data center, just the sheer number of servers. That's before you get to GCC and start walking down the rows of machines there, and you feel like you're part of something so much bigger than yourself, which is truly the part that I love about this place.
Each of these teams collaborate to make sure that Fermilab's day-to-day functioning is proper. And at the same time, we ensure that anything related to the IT is always up to date and functioning without any issues.
Our functioning goal is to make sure that IT and technology that we provide is aligned with the business functions across the laboratory. It's a lot of basically communications and a lot of analysis of data, a lot of analysis of applying architecture principles and architecture frameworks to try to solve some of these problems.
The last that I heard, we had something like 200 people working in IT alone. Instead of working as a big fish in a small pond, like you'll typically find at most IT organizations, I like to say it's a big fish in a big pond. If there's something that you don't know, there's at least 5 other people who have likely done something similar that you can talk to, whether they work in your group or not.
The ITD team is a very huge department. Each of them have many sections in them, like I'm part of the network services. The other such sections could be for the virtual services or the security services.
My part of the group is providing the database services. We have a couple people and technologies which run the databases for all the business processes at the lab. We also use the databases for the experiments. Experiments are not only in one institution, not only at Fermilab. Usually it is a worldwide collaboration.
My group is the authentication services team. We make sure you can log into the systems that you need to log into, whether that is your computer you are sitting down in front of or the machine that you are currently trying to connect to.
Our team was at SURF, that is the South Dakota area, and we have the tunnel at the 4850 level, and there was a request that if we could provide wireless at 4850 level, that is 4,850 feet below the surface. And our team, we managed to provide wireless to the miners, like, or the users at the 4850 level. So even though you're in a mine, you still have access to the internet.
Fermilab as a whole loves different technologies, as far as accelerator technologies, computing technologies, all kinds of different technologies. But at the end of the day, it really is about people and what are their motivations, what are their drivers, and what goals and outcomes are they trying to achieve. It's important that everybody realizes that they are part of the mission of the laboratory. It's like they may not be outside, they may not be doing great science, but they are key to making sure that the laboratory achieves this mission.
I'm not working to bring a company up to, you know, sell a product. I'm not working to help an organization figure out how to best market to, it's none of that. We're trying to figure out how the universe works. And how many people get to say, yeah, when I went to work today, ITRA was helping people figure out how we got here, which is really the coolest thing about this job, honestly.